From Fox 5 News, this is Good Day New York.
Let's talk about drug addiction. Problem for lots of people. Some people you may not even suspect may have a problem.
Well, Duke Castiglione took a look at young athletes when they injure themselves or put on drugs, painkillers sometimes, and then they get hooked. Duke, what's up?
You know, we've heard about professional athletes getting hooked on pain medication. Well, it can also happen to athletes at a much younger age. I met two young men who not only got addicted to opiate-based pain medication, but started using heroin as well.
When I was a freshman in high school, one of the plays, I was running after the quarterback when I was playing linebacker, and I tore my ACL and meniscus in my right leg. And when I went to the doctor after I had surgery, they prescribed me Vicodin.
For Joe Abadesa, now 23, that one Vicodin prescription led to a deep opiate addiction. He abused Percocet, oxycodone, OxyContin, and eventually heroin. He's been clean and sober for about 27 months now and working at his father's landscaping company. But his dark times were very dark.
It made me a very depressed person. I didn't want to live. If I woke up and I wasn't living, I thought that would be the easy way out.
Patrick Trevor, like Joe Abadesa, injured himself while playing high school sports and was prescribed opiates for pain.
I was playing lacrosse my junior year. I was a lacrosse goalie, and the way you hold the stick is like this, and your thumb sticks out off to the side, and someone came and took a sidearm shot, and they're about from me to you. So the ball came right in and hit the tip of my thumb. Ended up splitting the thumb down the side and breaking all these little bones in here.
The doctor prescribed Patrick 30 days of Roxycodone, and Patrick knew immediately he liked the way it made him feel, and soon became addicted, which eventually led to heroin as well. And to get money for these drugs, he started stealing.
At first I was stealing money, and then it was literally anything I can get my hands on. Like sterling silver spoon set I've stolen. I stole my mother's necklaces. Just went literally down to the local pawn shop.
A passionate musician, Patrick's been clean and sober for about 18 months now. Dr. Harris Straightner, New York Regional Vice President of the Karen Treatment Center, is a doctor of psychology and has specialized in addiction for over 30 years. He says this problem is all too common.
So you have seen a young person hurt a knee, hurt a back, go to the doctor, get prescribed an opiate-based drug and become addicted?
Repeatedly, and then turn to the street. First turn to the medicine cabinet, go to grandma's house, look for what grandma got, and then turn to the street when they can no longer get a hold of it.
Jim Snyder, program director at Dynamite Youth Center in Brooklyn, helped both Joe Abadesa and Patrick Trevor get clean. But he's seeing more and more young athletes become addicts.
I think sports are evolving, getting more and more competitive at a younger age, and people are pushing themselves harder and harder. And I think these injuries that maybe in my day, maybe a few years ago, weren't treated with so much medication, maybe more physical therapy, or maybe more people just played through the injury. Now they're getting prescribed this medication, and the results are a lot of these kids getting hooked.
James Hunt is on the front line of this epidemic. See, he's the acting special agent in charge of the DEA here in New York.
It's the number one priority for the office. It's the DEA's number one priority right now, opiate, prescription, drugs, and heroin. It's all over. There's dealers in the suburbs, there's dealers in the inner city, so it's not an urban problem, it's a urban and suburban problem.
If I'm a parent, my son or daughter hurts their knee, has surgery, gets a prescription for one of these drugs, what should I say to the doctor?
First 3 days? Yeah, you should say to the doctor, I don't want, first of all, what alternatives are there to medication that's addictive? Are there other things? Could they be on a pump in the hospital? Should I hold the medication?
Greg and Rosanna, both Patrick and Joe, doing very well. They wanted to share their stories to help other young people. And I will tell you, while doing this story, one of the things I found out is that because law enforcement is seizing more of these drugs and because there are more investigations and doctors across the country have become much more conservative writing these prescriptions, which is a good thing, But on the flip side, the pills are harder to get on the street. And because heroin is so much cheaper, that's what many addicts are turning to. Mm. The pills are $25 to $30 a pill, a single pill. So heroin for a little glycine is just $6 to $10. And that's what many addicts will turn to.
Sad.
Wow. All right, Duke, well done. Thank you very much.